Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to the Live and Five show where we are living live. I'm Jimmy Tang.
And I'm Alexis Nogues. You have another chance to have team spirit.
And the popular game called Gears of War is being pushed to fall with new features. Hang on to us for more scoop.
Will it be windy for the game today?
And were the Lakers able to win last night against the Utah Jazz?
All of this and much more.
In just a flash. Welcome back, and now to the news. What we told you yesterday was just an update of the spirit counts. The spirit race is still going on. The winners will be announced next week. The home run so far in the race is Mr. Hamamura with 100 points in the lead. Next is Ms. Burke with 91 points. After that, Ms. Nogal with 90 points. And the rest is Ms. Cairo with 88 points and Mr. Reagan with 76 points. These are not the official winners for spirit points. Your homeroom still has a chance to be on the top.
CGSF members will meet tomorrow at lunch in room 406. Please bring your service hour forms tomorrow in room 406 at lunch.
Last Tuesday, you received a flyer about the PTSA fundraiser. Please bring the flyer to your parents. PTSA is raising money to purchase a new sound system for Tetzloff's auditorium. Please place the donations in the envelope attached to the flyer and return it to your homeroom on Friday. The homeroom with the most donations will get a pizza party.
New Scholastic order forms have gone out to your English teacher. Be sure to pick one up. Book orders will go out every Friday this month. Cash or checks made out to the Scholastic are accepted. For more questions, head on to the library to see Ms. Espinoza.
Trojans are going head-to-head today after school. The boys' basketball and the girls' soccer team will be playing on Haskell's home field today, and the game will start at 3. Show them what you're made of, Trojans.
Be sure to bring your wallet and your appetite after school every Thursday, like tomorrow, outside the auditorium for some cheesy goodness. Chips and cheese are $2, and water is $1.
Gears of War is a third-person shooter game that is being developed by Epic Games and will be released for the Xbox 360 in 2011, so this year. It was originally going to come out in April of 2011, but was pushed back to fall of 2011. Gears of War will have a new four-player co-op with three playable female characters. The game will also feature new weapons like the digger launcher and weapons that dig through the ground and follows enemy players, then explodes when in range. The Gorgon pistol and four-weapon turret is also a new release. Gamers will have to wait until next fall to see this game. Sounds fun.
Yeah, sounds fun. Now it's time for your daily dispatch where Clarissa Weezer brings you today's music of the week.
Hey, Trojans, I'm Clarissa Weezer, and this week's music video is Rocketeer by Fires Movement. It's about a teenager's girlfriend leaving for a job, and they both are at a loss. So the teenager makes a jetpack and uses it on his skateboard. Let's take a look. Like a G6, chop the streets of Tokyo, get you fly kick. Girl, you always on my mind, got my head up in the sky, and I'm never looking down, feeling priceless. Yeah, where we at, only few have known. Want some next level Super Mario. I hope this works out, cardio. Till then, let's fly, Geronimo. Here we come with me. There's a
But I ain't never seen a face like yours. You made me feel like I could touch the planets. You want the moon, girl, watch me grab it. See, I ain't never seen a star this close. You got me stuck by the way you glow. I'm like, oh, 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 oh. I'm like, oh.
Thanks for watching. I'll see you next week for another music video.
Love that song. Okay, taking a look at Tetzloff's calendar, today is the Tetzloff Trojan Pride Day. Tomorrow is a CJSF meeting at lunch in room 406. Cheesy goodness is going to be sold after school, and college making it happen is at 6:30 p.m. And there's no school on Friday for student free day. And that wraps up the ongoing events. Now let's go to Victoria Lee with the weather. Good morning, Victoria.
Good morning.
morning, Alexis. There might be a chance of wind after school for the game. So, yeah, it might be cold then. But besides that, it's going to be the same as yesterday, like warm. So, yeah, let's take a look at the map.
It's going to be, it's going to be sunny on the West Coast and raining in the East Coast. Well, it's going to be windy down in Florida and Montana. Let's take a look at the 5-day forecast. It's going to be sunny for the rest of the week. Well, on Sunday, it's going to be mostly sunny with slight winds. And it's also going to be with high in the 70s. Let's bring it over to Tristan with the web poll.
Thanks, Victoria. Well, for today's web poll, I have Ariana. Now let's see what her comments and thoughts are. So, hi, Ariana.
Hi, Tristan.
How are you?
Good.
That's good. Well, did you read the web poll?
Should students be required to dress out for PE?
Well, here's the thing guys told us. Yes, it makes sense. Another one you guys said, I don't care. Well, we want to hear all your comments, thoughts, and opinions. Be sure to visit us online at LimeSideShow.com to vote. Send your comments to love poll, LimeSideShow.com. And if your comments are good, we'll read on the air. So, Ariana, what do you think?
No, because it takes too long to get dressed.
I agree. Well, thanks, Ariana.
You're welcome.
Okay. Well, I want to give a shout out to Victor. Happy birthday, Victor. And also shout out to Demetrius, Josh Navarro, and Anthony. Anyway, thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, that wraps up my time for today.
I'm Tristan Taylor. You guys have a nice day, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Back to you, Jenny.
Thank you, Tristan. Well, it's now time to swing into action with your Live and Five Sports Report with Aaron. Good morning, Aaron. How are you doing?
Good morning. Doing good. From the Northville to Southville and everything in between, this is your Live and Five Sports. I'm Aaron. The Lakers led all the way, defeating the Utah Jazz 120-91 last night. The Lakers earned their 7th straight win, but they handed the Utah Jazz their 5th loss in a row. And since leading scorer Eric Gordon was out last night and is going to be out for 3 weeks, the Clippers didn't do so well against Dallas, losing 105-112. Dallas has beaten the Clippers 8 straight times. And lastly, Anaheim Ducks were able to beat the Columbus Blue Jets 3-2. It was a close game, but the Ducks were able to come ahead. I'd like to give a shout out to Ashley Lopez. Yep, back to you, Jimmy.
Thank you, Aaron. Well, it's time to test your knowledge of today's Daily 411.
What was the first capital of the United States? Philadelphia, New York City, Washington, D.C., or Baltimore?
I know this. I learned this in Berk.
Me too.
New York City.
New York City.
Yeah, it's New York City.
Oh.
What?
We were wrong.
What?
No. Jimmy, you were wrong. I said Philadelphia. Philadelphia.
No.
Yeah, Ms. Burke taught us right.
Okay. I was thinking Philadelphia in my head, but I said New York City, so.
Okay.
Yeah. Visit our website to watch today's broadcast online at 115show.com and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube.
That's the end of today's show. We'll see you back here tomorrow morning.
Yeah.